Next item is this expensive, fancy, modern Gigabyte motherboard. And if they get angry at me for destroying it, yeah, I did sell it. Sold it for how much it's worth, but being eBay, of course I just had to sell it to a scammer. And this is what it looked like when I sent it. And this is what it looked like when I got it back. Oh, but I told eBay, and of course eBay takes their side, even though I had so much proof they damaged it. They clearly were either just scamming me or were incompetent because they put the wrong CPU in and squished it down. And I even told eBay that was proof because there was thermal paste on the CPU holder that was not there when I sent it. There was just all this evidence to show that they messed it up and crushed it. But of course eBay always sides with the buyer, and they said they had no evidence that the buyer damaged the item. Oh, that's eBay for you. Stupid! I bought it selling on eBay. Man, always just end up getting a return. What I gotta do with it? All that money down the drain. Of course, I gotta pay return shipping, because even though you select buyer pays return shipping, that doesn't actually mean anything on eBay. That's only if they do a change of mind return, which I'm sure no one in the history of eBay has ever done that. Because then they'll have to pay for the postage, so they just make me pay for it, and I'm losing all this money. And here I am just smashing at the bit. Make those pennies of revenue. And make sure no one else can use it. Stupid scam from eBay. eBay always taking their side. Yeah, you could buy billions of dollars on things on eBay and just return it all like this, and eBay would take your side every time. Always get your money back. Yeah, that's my rant for this video.